The style of Doris Humphrey's dancing is based on more natural body movement than something as artificial as ballet, where legs are all the way turned out and people dance on their toes. It doesn't mean that it's easy. Doris Humphrey was one of the great American modern dance pioneers and was active in the first half of the 20th century. She's a native Oak Parker, born here in 1895, spent most of her childhood actually down in the city of Chicago, where her father had worked as the manager of the Palace Hotel, which was an interesting hotel because it catered to people who were in vaudeville. And it was a very colorful place for a child to grow up. Doris was in the first ever kindergarten and then later high school graduation class at Francis Parker School, and studied dance there with Mary Wood Hinman, who had collected folk dances from all over the world. Doris came back after high school and taught here at the Art League building and at the Frank Lloyd Wright Unity Temple. She taught classes for children as well as classes in ballroom dance. Doris felt she was stifled here in Oak Park. Mary Wood Hinman suggested that she go west to study at the Denishawn School that was being run by Ruth St. Denis and Ted Shawn. The Denishawn School taught all kinds of different dance forms: ballet, yoga, flamenco, Native American, Greek dancing. Towards the end of her years with Denishawn, the entire company took a two-year tour to the Far East. And it was that exposure that drove both Doris Humphrey and Martha Graham to both rebel. They wanted to develop a way of moving and a way of dancing that was uniquely their own and uniquely American. These two great women went on to do exactly that. It was based on a principle of movement that Doris worked on all her life: fall and recovery. And it was based on the use of the breath as a motivator for that, and that in exhaling, the body tended to fall, and then as you inhale, you would recover. And she took that fundamental idea of being human and turned it into a dance form where the breath informed the shape of the movement. Falls could dramatically crash to the floor or wilt slowly. Another kind of thing that she used in her movement was something called succession. And successional movement probably is best known when you think of somebody like Michael Jackson and people doing a waveform. A succession can be something that happens in a group of people where one will fall and they gradually fall in a cannon form, or it can be taken just in the gesture of an arm or a hand or throughout the entire body. I honestly don't know of another school in the United States that can say that they have three levels of Humphrey technique. I think Doris Humphrey would be very pleased to see the children in this school.